Hi, I'm Billy. I grow my plants using the hydroponics method, specifically Kratky. In the original Kratky method, you will find a container that is big enough and deep enough to hold all the nutrient solution your plant will need from seedling to harvest. Then you put the nutrient solution in and your seedling in, and all you go. You don't need to watch it or take care of it until harvest. This is very nice. But practically, some of the plants will just get too thirsty and it drinks up all the nutrient solution before you can harvest, like tomato or other fruits. So I am using a modified Kratky method where I will replenish the nutrient up to 2 centimeters water level, that is 2 centimeters from the base of the tank, of the, your growth tank. There are only 2 methods to keep your growth tank at 2 centimeters water level. The first one is manually watching and monitoring the water level and then replenish the nutrient almost every day. The second method is to use a flow valve. Connect your flow valve to a big nutrient tank, which is located a little bit higher than your growth tank, and then through gravity pull, the nutrient will flow to the growth tank through your growth valve. Your flow valve will be able to control and limit the maximum nutrient level at around 2 centimeters from the bottom of your growth tank. And this will ensure your plant, whether it's a fruit or a lettuce, will contain enough nutrient solution, and yet at least 1/3 of the roots will be in nutrient, the other 2/3 will be in the air, absorbing enough air for its growth. In this video, I'm going to show you how to build these vertical hydroponic systems for the non-circulating modified Kratky method of hydroponics. You can buy this type of trolleys from any vendor, but the one I am looking at can be ordered from IKEA. And the growth tank is also an IKEA product. So let me show you how I did it. If you like my video, please support me by clicking like, subscribe, and share with your friends too. The idea of this project actually started from this product I saw online from IKEA. I wonder how easy it will be to turn it into a vertical hydroponic system with passive non-circulating Kratky method. I just need to put the nutrient tank on the top tray of the trolley, and then I have the bottom 2 trays with the growth tank. For the grow lights, we can mount it at the base of the tray above our growth tank. So the first thing we need to do is to order it. While we wait for this order to be delivered, let's start working on the seeds and seedling and germination. It takes 1 week to grow from seeds to seedling with the roots long enough to touch the base of the tank. So before we start building our system, let's start the germination process. So we put a paper towel in a container, a narrow container, and then put in the seeds. These are lettuce seeds, and spray it with a lot of water. The water needs to be enough to moist the paper towel completely. Then we put everything in a seed bag. The idea of the seed bag is to keep the moisture all inside a confined space, so the seedling will always have water. Then put the whole thing on a cardboard or anywhere without direct sunlight. Monitor the water level and keep it moist every time. I got my trolley delivered, so I just follow the instruction to install the trolley. It's not too difficult, just need to follow the instruction and prepare to use the screws and screwdriver. Then we'll need to mount some aluminium paper at the base of each tray so it can reflect the light from the LED properly. And then we will mount the LED grow lights. We are using the conventional LED for home lighting. The power rating is 18 watts, 1/8, and the color temperature is the same as the sunlight. This is how it looks when it's all mounted. Make sure you mount the terminal so we can connect the 220 volts in electricity. Because the frame is made of metal, we need to ensure the earth terminal of the electric cable gets mounted to the frame, the metallic frame as well. Otherwise, there may be chances of electric shock if something goes wrong. So make sure you have the earthing of the electricity mounted to the frame. So after connecting all the cable, let's test the lights. The light is pretty strong. I've tested it, it's around 60,000 lux, so it should be enough to shine and let your plant grow. To be safe, I test the frame to see if there's any stray electricity by using the testing screw. If there's stray electricity, we'll see the light up. It's best to light up the grow lights for around 18 hours a day, 1/8. So you may want to turn it on 7 a.m. and shut it down 10 p.m. To do that, you can use this type of auto power on-off switches. You can just program it with the right time and it will do the job for you. Next, we need to buy this tray for our growth bed for the vegetable. We need two of these. We also need one deeper tray to be used as the nutrient tank at the top. These are the trays I got. Two shallow trays for growth tank and one nutrient tank, the black one, which is very deep. For the nutrient tank, you need to select the black color. The size of the tray should fit the tray on the trolley. However, because there's a central pole that supported the trolley, that one is getting in the way. So what I have to do is cut a small notches to avoid the conflict. Then we need to drill a 5 mm hole from around 2 cm from the top so we can fit in our nutrient pipe. Next, put the tray back into the trolley. This is how it looks. Then we can cut a foam board, the black one, to block the light and drill as many holes as you need to grow your vegetable. We'll put in the neck cup afterwards with the vegetable in a cotton. Use the hot glue gun to stick the base of the flow valve onto the growth tank. Make sure it didn't fall off. Then we can connect the water pipe into the growth valve. Make sure it's tight and not leaking. We can now install the flow valve onto the base and fasten it using the nuts. There are many flow valves available in the market. Just choose the one that fits you, or you can DIY yourself. Just look at the link in my video. There's one that I designed using 3D printer that you can make yourself. For each of the growth tank, we need to pull the water pipe onto the top of the trolley and connect it with the nutrient tank. This is the first one and the second one. I have drilled a hole in the nutrient tank and put a T-joint there so we can connect with the two water pipes, one for each growth tank. Just make sure that your nutrient tank will not leak and use hot glue gun to fix it. You can buy the hydroponic nutrient solutions from many shops. They usually come into two types, the A and the B, and you need to mix them together according to the ratio. For mine, it's 1 to 300. That means every 1 gram of nutrient solution, you need 300 gram of water to mix it. So first I put in the A solution, stir it hard enough to avoid deposits, and then the B solution. I also stir it strongly to avoid any chemical reaction. Next is to measure the pH and the EC value of your nutrient solution. It will be different depending on which type of plant you are growing. I'm growing lettuce, so the pH value must be between 5.6 and 6.2. And the EC electronic connectivity must be between 0.8 to 1.2, or in my meter is 800 to 1200. I'm using this meter that combined both pH function and EC function on the same meter. I just select the right mode. I can measure the EC first. The unit is microsiemens per cm cube. The value measured is around 1200, that means 1.2. It's a little bit high, so I will add some water to dilute it and then measure again. Next is the pH value. So let's select the pH mode. Okay, it's 6.9. It's a little bit off, so I'll need to add something. There are some pH adjustment solution you can add. The left one is for increasing the pH. The right one is for decreasing the pH. Since my pH is a little bit higher, I'll add something on the right pH minus to reduce the pH down to 6.2, and then I'll come back and measure again. Now is the time to turn on the tap and get the nutrient solution down to the growth tank. The flow valve will make sure the maximum water level will not go above 2 cm. I have fast forward and you can see the water stays at 2 cm. Next, we will put our seedling into the net cup. Make sure the root is long enough to touch the bottom of the tank. Otherwise, it will dry up. So make sure the root didn't stick to the wall and it reaches the bottom of your growth tank. Let's take a last peek to make sure everything is okay. Okay, that's fine. And there you have it, a vertical, passive, non-circulating, modified Kratky hydroponic system that you can grow your plants, be it lettuce or fruit. It will always be replenished with enough nutrient keeping a maximum water level of 2 centimeters. I made a top cover for the nutrient tank with a piece of wood to make it look nice. And I can use that surface to put in my nursery to plan for the next growth cycle. So that's it. That's the whole project. I will spend some time to talk about the time required for each stage. For seed germination, it usually takes within 7 days. For lettuce, you will see the seedling coming out on the second day. From seedling to grow to a stage where the root is long enough to touch the tank, it will take another week. So the first 2 weeks, you'll be spending in the nursery. And then the seedling can be transplanted into the net cup and the cotton, put in the growth tank. From then on, it will take between 6 to 8 weeks to harvest. So my system is also just started right now. I will share the harvest video with you at the 8th week. Until then, this is the end of the video. If you like my video, click like, subscribe, and share with your friends too. Bye now.